Today we are heading to Spanish Point Beach for a beach day, charged up to 100%. It says for the last 50 kilometers, my average projected range is 482 kilometers, should be fine. I'll see if I can kind of make it in one charge, but no guarantees. Well, it's 11:11, so the stars are aligned and everything looks good. It's currently 16 degrees Celsius. We hope that it will be around 19 or 20 by the time we reach Spanish Point. It's 2.5 hours, or I think close to 3 hours drive. Yeah, a lot to do for a beach, but yeah, when you have to go, you have to go. Okay, that's the route. It says we will reach Spanish Point with 28% battery, 273 kilometers, around 3 hours in the afternoon sometime. I am pretty sure the way I drive, this is not going to be 28, but it will probably be around 40% left by the time I reach. Let's see when I reach and where we are. So just 25 minutes into the drive, we are averaging at 176 watt hours per kilometer, and the trip already shows that we'll be reaching there with 37, so I am right on the money. I think we'll reach there with around 40% or 45% left, so yeah, if I drive with the same efficiency. Let's see what happens. I'll keep you guys posted. Navigate on autopilot, motorway driving, 100 kilometers per hour. Yeah, that's my sweet spot. I think for the best efficiency, if you want to gain any time on the motorway driving, I think this is it. Yeah, the speed limit is 120. I'm driving at 100. Doesn't really matter. Just be in the slow lane or the passing lane. Put it on cruise control, autopilot, 100 kilometers, and you'll be grand. It just adds like around 30-35 minutes to your overall journey, but definitely reduces a lot of anxiety of changing lanes or changing speeds and all that stuff. And also the efficiencies is the best one that I can get. Alright?
Down lovely beach, amazing people. all across Ireland. I think that's one of the beauties of this island. It's Sunday, so I'm expecting, and I think this is the last weekend before the schools open up, so I'm expecting a lot of families, kids on the beach, and it could be pretty crowded. It's a very long stretch of beach, so shouldn't be a problem. Yeah, on the left you can see the beach now. I haven't had an issue parking there in my previous visits, given that I have not seen many Teslas pulling up to Spanish Point exactly the moment that I have pulled up. So I am just hoping my luck doesn't run out today, and looking at how dense the parking spaces are here, that's my bet to get a parking space in the Armada Hotel. Given that EV adoption is on the rise, but it's still not where it should be. And also given that the infrastructure is also not where it should be, but having these Tesla destination chargers is really a boon. These are mostly free for use. Armada Hotel, you can just pull up and plug it in and charge. You don't really need to call the hotel up to ask if you can park it. You cannot reserve it. You can maybe if you call the hotel and say that you need EV chargers, you might put a reserved spot over there, but otherwise it's kind of open to use. On the left hand side, that's the actual car park for the beach. It's super handy, just park there and walk to the beach. The beach is really beautiful. It's white sandy beach, a lovely view. I hope the weather continues to be around 19-20 degrees Celsius so that I can take a dip, and yeah, we are almost close to our final destination on this trip. The efficiency has been super awesome. Like, this has been the best that I have received on a motorway since in the last 6 months, that's since I got the car. And yeah, it's been super awesome driving through Ireland. The motorway is seeing all the greenery. Always a pleasure. On the right, that's Spanish Point House. That's a very nice bread and breakfast. It's a luxury bread and breakfast, so you can definitely plan a trip to stay over there if you want to. So even near Armada Hotel, there is roadside parking. People have been parked up. I'm just hoping that we have that parking spot. Alright, so here's the moment of truth. Pulling in. Okay. And near the brown shed you see some green spots. That's there's a e-Niro already parking and charging. Alright, there's one spot. There are two spots actually, so that's good. Whew! Yeah, so we have our parking spot available, and that's awesome, and I'm super happy about this. Alright, so we are all parked up. I'll plug it in so that I don't want to kind of abuse the parking spot or the e-charging spot if I'm not plugging in. So please do that if you are parking into a charging spot. It is not a parking space. It is a place where you actually park only when you need to charge. So yeah, be mindful of that for other users. But other than that, I think this is pretty awesome. To summarize the journey, I was driving a Tesla Model 3 long range, went to Spanish Point, it's in County Clare. The distance from Dublin is 273 kilometers, left at 11:15 a.m. The temperature when we left was 16 degrees Celsius, the temperature at arrival was 19 degrees. The estimated arrival time when we left was around 2 p.m. and actually we arrived at around 2:30, so it's just around 18 to 20 minutes added. So this is what I was talking about, like if you drive around 100 kilometers per hour, even in a 120 kilometers per hour lane, speed lane, you will just need additional 18 to 20 minutes or 30 minutes max to reach your destination, which is from my side totally acceptable. The departure state of charge was 100%. It estimated that we'll reach with 28%, but as we predicted, like okay, the actual arrival state of charge was 45%, which is 17 percentage point higher than what the estimation was. This also, this is a testament of driving efficiently. Like you always will have more charge left. The energy consumption was 146 watt hours per kilometers. So the final metric, we drove 273 kilometers using 55% of the battery. That means that if we prorate this, the prorated range on single charge is just shy of 500 kilometers. It's 496 kilometers, which is plenty for driving around anywhere in Ireland. Mostly you might need a single charge somewhere if you're going from like the northern tip to the southern tip. But apart from that, I think this range is phenomenal, and driving efficiently does have its own gains. So driving in the city doesn't matter that much, but if you're driving on the motorway and if you have to go a distance more than say 300 kilometers, like I would recommend driving around 100 kilometers per hour on the motorways. That steady speed is really my sweet spot. Like I have had no issues driving in that pace, and as you can see, it is very efficient and it's good for the battery, it's good for the car, it's good for you itself. Like I have so much mental peace while I'm driving at 100 kilometers. I don't need to worry about who I need to overtake next and lane changes and whatever it is, or speed cameras. So yeah, I think this is the way you can achieve the best efficiency from your electric vehicle. I will not just say Tesla, but any electric vehicle. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you really liked it, a like and a subscribe to the channel would be splendid. Thank you so much. Have a good one. Bye-bye.